Hello, it's Carly McAvoy. I'm doing systems of equation word problems. These two are mixture problems. So when you're mixing things together, how do you get a solution that you're looking for? This one says one solution is 20% salt and the other is 30% salt. How many liters of each should be mixed to get 24 liters of a solution that is 22.5% salt? I mean, this might be for like fish tanks where you have to have a certain salinity in your fish for your fish to live or whatever. I don't know what that should be. 22.5 seems high for that. But some kind of saline solution. Just take a second to explain what we're talking about with mixture problems. Let's say we had a container here and we wanted to add liquid in. And from one source, we're adding liquid in. This is one spigot. And from the other, we're adding a different source in. Right? Maybe you can't tell those are two different colors. But anyway, one of them is 20% solution and the other one is a 30% solution, and they're both going into the same container. And so we're going to mix those up and we're going to have a solution that's no longer 20 or 30. It's a mixture of the two. Now, I only want to get to 22.5%. So in my head, I'm saying I'm going to need more of the 20 because I'm closer to 20 than I am 30, what I want altogether. But I don't know. Okay, so what I'm going to do is say in my first mixture comes in, and I don't know how much it is. I'm going to call it X, but I do know that that one's going to be a 20%. That's a X number of liters at 20%. And then I'm going to have Y number of liters at 30%. And again, I don't know how much of the X and how much of the Y I need, but what I do know is that when this stuff comes out of here, I'm going to have 24 liters altogether. And my 24 liters is going to be at 22.5%. Okay, now this is the at symbol. It doesn't look like it. Okay, so whenever I have a mixture and a percentage, I multiply those together. And I'm going to tell you that the stuff inside the container gets added together because it's getting mixed together, and it equals what's outside the container. Now, what you might have seen if you work through some other textbooks or examples, that they set up a table and they have you fill out the table. And if that works for you, then do that. I prefer to think about it in the bucket because I can visualize it better. But remember this, the first equation always has to do with the number of liters. And the second equation has to do the percentage. So in the first one, I'm just looking at the number of liters. And then in the second equation, I'm looking at the percent of the mixture. I think about it that way. So in the first one, I'm just saying, how many liters do I have? Well, I know that I have 24 liters altogether because I was told I want 24 liters. And what do I have that makes up the 24? Well, I have X and Y. So I have X plus Y equals 24. There's one of my equations. My second mixture percentage problem, I just multiply each one of these things from the first equation with its corresponding percent. Remember to change it to a decimal. So 20% is 0.2. So I have 0.2 or 0.20, whichever you want to write, of times X. And then for 30, that's 0.3 or 0.30. I don't always write those on, but 0.3y. And then I have 24 times 0.225. Okay, so that's just taking directly above it and multiplying each one of those with the percent that goes with it. This is the percent of salt in the X, percent of salt in the Y, and the percent of salt that we want to end up with in our final 24 ounces. Now I'm going to make this a little simpler by multiplying 24 times 0.225. And whoops, I didn't get that in there. 24 times 0.225. And that gives me 5.4. So that makes my equation a little nicer. 2x plus 3y, 0.3y, sorry, 0.2x 0.3y equals 5.4. Now, I can solve that equation with the decimals in, you can too, but I'm going to get rid of them. If I want to move everything so that I get rid of the three decimal places, the decimal in all three of these problems, I'm going to multiply by 10. And that's going to move this over, that over, and that over. And I'm going to have an equation with no decimals. So final version of this equation is going for me to solve is 2x plus 3y equals 54. And now your choice. You can rearrange this and use substitution, or you can multiply and get rid of that by elimination. And I'm going to use elimination in the first one. I've got a second example where I'll use the other method. So I want to eliminate, let's say, the x's. I'm going to multiply everything in this equation by negative 2. Negative 2 times x, negative 2x. Negative 2 times y, negative 2y. Negative 2 times 24 is negative 48. And now I can add those together because the x's will drop out, and I get y equals 54 minus 48 is 6. So I need 6 liters of the y solution. If I need 24 liters altogether, I know that I can just subtract the 6 and see that I need 18 liters of the x solution, which I said in the beginning, I'm going to need more of this because I'm close to 20. I'm only going up to 22.5, so that makes sense. So I have 6 liters at 30%, and I have 18 liters at 20%. And that mixture would get me 24 liters altogether, and it would mix to give me 22.5% salt. Okay, second one. Kira plans to mix triple sec, which is 30% alcohol, with grain alcohol, which is pure alcohol, to get a mixture that is 47.5% alcohol. How much grain alcohol is needed, and how much triple sec is if and how much triple sec if she needs 36 ounces of the mixtures for the night? The mixture, I think. She needs to have this mixture to put in drinks or whatever. So I'm going to say same thing we did before. She's going to make a concoction where she puts in triple sec being 30% alcohol, and she adds grain alcohol, which is 100% alcohol, okay? And she needs to get 36 ounces altogether. So she's going from 30 up to 47, but that's a lot closer than the 100, right? So again, I think we have more triple sec than grain alcohol. So I'm going to say that T is the amount of triple sec, and that's at 30%. And G is the amount of grain alcohol, and that's 100%. How much does she have altogether? Well, altogether, she wants 36 ounces, and she wants it to be 47.5% proof. All right? So our two equations, like we saw before, the first one just has to do with how many ounces does she need. Well, she has T plus G equals 36 ounces. That's how many ounces she wants. And then we're going to take each of those and multiply it times our percentage. So 30% equals 0.3 because we're moving that tube to the left. 100% equals 1 because if you have a decimal point here and you move it two places, you've got 1, right? So I have 0.3 times T, and then 1 times G, which I don't even need to write, but I'm just going to for now. And then 36 times 0.475. That's our percentage that we're shooting for. So let's make that simpler. 36 times 0.475 is 17.1. So I have 0.3T plus G equals 17.1. Now, I could solve that equation right now without getting rid of decimals, or I could multiply by decimals. I'm going to go ahead and multiply by 10 because I want to get rid of decimals. I like to do things with no decimals in them, but surely you've got a calculator. You can make that choice. Be careful here. This is 3t. This is 10 times g or 10g, and this is 171. Okay, last one we did elimination. This one I'm going to do substitution. So I'm going to take t plus g equals 36, and I'm going to subtract g from both sides and get t equals 36 minus g. And so now instead of t, I'm going to say 3 times 36 minus g plus 10g equals 171. Your choice, whether you want elimination or substitution, that's totally up to you. I have 36 times 3, which is 108, minus 3g plus 10g equals 171. 171 minus 108 is 63. And 10 minus 3 is 7, and divide both sides by 7, and you get g equals 9. What does that mean? That means we have 9 ounces of grain alcohol. If we have 36 ounces altogether, how many ounces do we have of triple sec? Well, we have triple sec plus 9 equals 36. And subtract 9 from both sides, that means she's putting 27 ounces of triple sec in. So we have 27 ounces of triple sec. All right, so that's going to give us 36 ounces of this mixture that then she can use that night while she's tending bar. Okay, have a fantastic day.